For the Office of Naval Research, we're exploring ways to make human-robot teams more integrated.
In Lexington, we're doing a lot of mapping in unstructured environments in the forest, around the areas of Massachusetts, and we really wanted to apply it to a new domain.
We have a novel approach of doing real-time undersea mapping using various vision systems.
We built the brains of a robot, all the processing and sensors packed into a tube. We have cameras, an IMU, hydrophones, GPS, and a parallel processor. This world-class autonomy range in Kwajalein allowed us to test our work in the undersea domain as well.
And there's probably no place in the world where you can have access to this kind of rapid prototyping laboratory on an island where you can dive right off the beach to test your equipment.
They've done an amazing job in the last few years really building a research environment for undersea mapping and for the littoral in Kwajalein.
Our rig is capable of doing everything in real time while we're swimming around. The research focuses on determining position and orientation accurately and fast. What we're doing is conducting three experiments on board so we can cross-validate our results. One of the biggest challenges to displaying information intuitively to a human is accurately determining the observer's pose, especially on gear that can be easily carried.
So the gear that we brought out here, we're leaving here. Our basic research is wrapping up, and we wanted to be able to leave something that can live on beyond the program.
So with software updates, we can prove out algorithms here.
Determining pose in unstructured environments is key for many future missions, from human-robot teaming to autonomous vehicles, such as UUVs, unmanned surface vehicles, and UAVs.
Well, as far as this test campaign goes, I think it was 110% successful. We met all our goals coming out here, and then we did a little bit more.